हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी टेक सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ इंडेफिनेट इंटीग्रेशन एज इंटीग्रेशन बाय पार्ट्स। एज द चैप्टर इज डिवाइडेड इनटू थ्री पार्ट्स, फर्स्ट पार्ट दैट वी सीन ऑलरेडी इंटीग्रेशन बाय सब्स्टिट्यूशन, नाउ सेकेंड पार्ट इंटीग्रेशन बाय पार्ट्स एंड थर्ड पार्ट इंटीग्रेशन बाय पार्शियल फ्रैक्शन। Now in the second part of this chapter, integration by parts means we take integral of product of two functions. Suppose we take two functions, first function is u and second function is v, both are functions of x, then we can take integration of product of these two functions with respect to x, as u and v are functions of x. So how you find this integral? For this we take result as u into integral v dx minus, here we take double integration as outer integral, again find derivative of u and integral of v, means we take integral of v multiplied by derivative of u with respect to x and product with the derivative of the integration, again whole that product is integrated with respect to x. That result may be written as integral u into integral v dx minus, this is outer integral, here we take derivative of u with respect to x, that can be multiplied by integration of this v with respect to x, and again this product with the integration with respect to x, means we may interchange this product terms. First we write derivative of u, after this we can write integral of v. Now this is the rule or theorem for integration by parts, means how to find integration of product of two functions. Now we prove this result for taking solution as very easy result. Now here we take derivative term for u and therefore we take the integration for v with respect to x, that is w. So by definition of integration, you know that integration is nothing but antiderivative, so that v can be separated by taking differentiation. So we get here this v is equal to derivative of w with respect to x. Now here two terms of the derivative, that in the theorem is du by dx, and in the corresponding substitution for the integral v dx, we get dw by dx. So we can take here, consider the derivative of product of u into w, because already we know derivative of u and w. So by applying derivative of product, we take that rule as u into derivative of w plus w into derivative of u. Derivative of product, first function multiplied by derivative of second plus second function multiplied derivative of first. Now for this we take only replacement as d by dx of u into w is equal to u into, take down here value of dw by dx from above step, that is v plus w into du by dx. Here again we may use value of w as integral v dx. Now we take here by definition of integration means we take whole equation is integrated with respect to x, so that implies here left side is free from derivative because integration is antiderivative. Derivative cancel with antiderivative. So we get left side is u into w. For right side we take integral u into v plus w into du by dx whole integration with respect to x. So apply algebra for integration. Integration of addition of two function is addition of their integration. So we take here integral uv dx plus integral w into du by dx with respect to x. Now left side is as it is, u into w. So how you simplify this? So this is our left side for proof, integral uv dx. Here only we take value of w, and for left side we take again value of w. So what is value of w? W is equal to, so we get u integral v dx is equal to integral u into v dx plus, now here take value of w again. What is value of w? W is equal to integral v dx multiplied by this du by dx, and this integral means we take here bracket with the integration with respect to x. Now this is left side, so only we can shift this side to the left side. So that result becomes integral u into v dx is equal to, now this term remains to the right side as it is, only we can shift this term. So first term is u integral v dx, and this becomes negative, minus outer integral, again this integral, multiply derivative of u, and whole integral of the product, integral v dx into du by dx. So that proves the corresponding result as integration by parts, means product of two function. Now when we take u as a first function and v as a second function, so that choice of u and v, according to the rule of choice of function, LIATE, late rule, means we take L for logarithmic function, I for inverse T function, then A for algebraic function, again T for trigonometric function, and this E for exponential function. Because if, for example, we take integral x square into e raised to x dx, and we can solve by using both method, either x square is u and e raised to x is v, or either e raised to x is u and integral u raised to integral e raised to x as u and x square as v. So we get two different answer, but to take the integral by this second choice, we get that cannot be evaluated easily, and therefore to avoid this, we use the rule for choice of first function and second function by using the Liet rule. So integration by parts, in that topic we take first result for theorem. Instead of u and v, there may be functions fx and gx. We prove same result for this and find the corresponding integration. Now in this again we take some results for integration by parts. We get here result for integration by parts. There are three standard result: integration of root of a square minus x square with respect to x. So that answer for the integration is x by 2 into same root a square minus x square. Here we get plus a square by 2, and before this we find the integral of 1 upon root. Use that result as sine inverse x upon a, and plus constant of integration. Now the same reason for the function integral a square plus x square, and third result for integral. Here we take addition and difference of the, now for first we take minus sign is common, so we get integral of x square minus a square with respect to x. Now all these three result can be obtained by integration by parts. So we take here first term as it is, for this x by 2 into under root of a square plus x square, same term is here, x by 2 root of x square minus a square. the three result we take first term as it is, because every time we can take first function is not given. So we take this is the product of root of a square minus x square into 1. So we take first function is this algebraic, and second is again algebraic function. But before this, we know we cannot find directly the integral of root of a square minus x square, and therefore we take that function as a u, and v be the value of 1, because we know integration of 1 as well as derivative of 1. So here again we take second term, start from a square by 2, and find right here integral of 1 upon root of a square plus x square, that is log of mod of x plus under root of x square plus a square, or you may take a square plus x square plus c. Same result for this, only we take when the square of constant has negative sign. Then here that second term becomes negative, minus of a square by 2 log of mod of x plus under root of here that root as it is x square minus a square plus c. Now we can prove this result one by one, because in the board final paper one of the result asked in the question paper. So we prove all these three result, but before this you may take by integration by parts. There are five theorems actually. First is this, next three are this, and after this we take one of the theorem, that integral of e raised to x. We see after this, before this we can prove one of the result from this. So suppose we take proof of first result, all these result have same proof. So proof of the first result, as we take integral root of a square minus x square dx. Now first of all we say that integral means solution, or the corresponding integration, call that integral as I is nothing but integral a square minus x square. Remember that here we say integral as I. If you cannot denote that by I, then you cannot get answer, because in the theorem of a square minus x square, for right side we get x by 2, and for second term again a square by 2. This divide 2 means we get 2 times integral to the left side, means twice I. And therefore for this notification of I, we indicate given integral as I. So we take this value of integration for evaluation, integration by parts. So we take second function as 1 and integration with respect to x. So call that is u and that is v. So by ip, integration by parts, I is equal to, now we take here integral u into v dx by using the rule, first function multiplying integral of second minus outer integral, again integral of second function multiplying derivative of first, and again whole integration with respect to x. So by using this we take integral of this under root. So we take first function as root of a square minus x square, integration of v means 1 dx, minus outer integral, again we take inner integral, same integral is repeated here, integral 1 dx multiplying derivative of u is nothing but under root of a square minus x square. After finding this derivative and integration, that whole product is integrated again with respect to x. Now take this integral of 1, integral of 1 with respect to x is only x, minus again same integral, that is x, and derivative of this under root upon under root of a square minus x square. So we use here derivative of root x, so that results 1 upon 2 times root of a square minus x square, but this is composite function, so we take again multiplication of derivative of a square minus x square. Before this, derivative of a square is 0 and derivative of x square is 2x, but it has minus sign, so we take minus 2x, and therefore we take integral and whole this derivative with their product, again that integrated with respect to x. So we get that term as I is equal to x into root of a square minus x square minus, now take here, these two cancel out with these two, this x and this x becomes x square, but sign is negative. We cannot make this minus minus plus, because for denominator we need sign of square term with variable x as negative. So we take this is as it is, because we take only adjustment of a square. Now for such a type of integral, we take adjustment of this denominator at numerator by addition of x square, by addition of a square with the subtraction of a square. For numerator, we take addition of a square in the term minus of x square and subtract minus a square from this minus x square in order to take adjustment of denominator. Now, separate this x integral a square minus x square minus. Now, if we take separation of this integral, just like x upon root x, so we get that integral minus x upon root x, means we get here root x means root of a square minus x square with respect to x. Now this minus minus becomes plus for a square. For this integral we take here a square upon root of a square minus x square whole integral with respect to x. This is very important step, because at this step we take separation as well as dividation and find corresponding integral. So I becomes x into root of a square minus this integral is nothing but I. This, now here we take, this is the integral which is given to you. So we take here, that is I plus, now here a square is constant, integral of 1 upon root of a square minus x square dx. Again, this is standard result, as we seen already this integral of 1 upon a square minus x square, that integral is nothing but first two terms remains as it is. See here, this is minus I plus a square, integral of this log of 1 upon a square minus x square, integral of this, as we know a is constant, so we take that is sine inverse of x upon a. Once we take this I shifted to the left side, so we take here addition of constant of integration, suppose that is small c. Integral of 1 upon root of a square minus x square is sine inverse of x upon a. Now shift this I to the left side. Here first already one of the I is present. This I is added to the left side. For right side we get here x into root of a square minus x square plus a square sine inverse x upon a plus small c. Now this I plus I is 2i. We call that value addition 2i. From this we can shift 2, and therefore we get lastly value of I is equal to, this 2 is shifted, this 2 is divided to whole these two term, 3 terms. So we can take separation, x by 2 into root of a square minus x square. Again this 2 is divided to second term, a square by 2 into sine inverse of x upon a plus capital C, where this capital C is equal to small c by 2. We get direct result for this, and therefore you take, when you get I to the right side, that give always minus sign. So by using same technique, we can find integral of root of x square plus a square and root of x square minus a square. Now see here, for under root of x square plus a square, up to this we get same. Only here find we derivative of this 1 upon 2 times, and derivative of x square is 2x. So there is no doubt about that minus sign. That minus sign remains here as it is. X into x, x square becomes positive. We take addition and subtraction of a square. Now for second result, x square minus a square, when a square has negative sign, at that time again we take that a square with the minus sign as it is, and here adjustment of again plus a square and minus a square. So the second and third result is for plus and minus. You get the same answer with the same method of proof. You may prove this result by using the same result, root of x square plus a square, root of x square minus a square. Again here, result of integration. To prove the integral e raised to x function plus its derivative with respect to x, we get that answer e raised to x into fx plus c. Now for this type of integral, here common coefficient is e raised to x, and we take addition of the function with its derivative, that whole integration with respect to x gives e raised to x into fx. Now again this is the result by integration by parts, because fx plus fx f dash x, for this we take, for proof of this result we take substitution as put e raised to x into fx is equal to t, because already we take I is equal to integral of e raised to x inside the bracket fx plus f dash x. So for this we take substitution as, because when we take e raised to x in the product rule of function with derivative, at that time its derivative remains as it is. So for this we take here differentiation of this with respect to x. So for left side we use product rule, e raised to x as it is, first function multiply derivative of second plus second function multiply derivative of first, and to the right side we get dt by dx to find derivative with respect to x. Now for left side we take e raised to x as a common factor, and at the same time this dx is shifted. Again here first we write function and then derivative in order to get the integrand, and dx is shifted to the left side, we get the value of dt. So you see that this is your integrand, e raised to x fx plus f dash x with respect to x, and therefore I is equal to, now this whole value is nothing but dt, integral e raised to x inside the bracket fx plus f dash x multiplied by dx, that value becomes dt. So you know that dt means integral of 1 with respect to t. So integral of 1 with respect to t means t plus c. But what is the law of t? T is nothing but e raised to x into fx, and take constant of integration which is added. And therefore we get very easy or important result, integral e raised to x fx plus f dash x dx is equal to e raised to x fx plus c. Now by using this we find integration of product of two functions. In this case we cannot take the choice of the function, but this is application for the result, as we find integral of e raised to x into cos of bx plus c with respect to x, and again integral e raised to x into sin of bx plus c with respect to x. For this we take answer of the integral as integral of e raised to ax into cos bx plus c. For this we take there are three constant, a, b and c. As a, b, c are three constant, so we take for the proof of the result, taking integration by parts, by without choice of u and v, you may take here first function e raised to x and second function cos bx plus c, or you may take first function cos bx plus c and second e raised to x, but we get same answer for this, and therefore we get answer for the integral e raised to x upon a square plus b square. Remember that here first constant is a. So we take a times that function as it is. Now for second constant is b. We start second term with b and writing the integration of cos, because we know that integration of cos is plus sine. So we take here plus second constant with the integral of cos sine bx plus c. Again bracket complete and take down here constant of integration. You may take that is c. So with the help of this we find second result, e raised to x upon a square plus b square into, here again first constant a, write that function. So here we take sine bx plus c. Now for second term we take second constant is b, but when we write second term, at that time we have to find integral of this sine. What is integral of sine? Minus cos bx plus c, and take down addition of constant. Again these are very important result in order to find integration of e raised to x into cosine or sine function, because when we take substitution of some examples, then that type of questions ask in the question paper of CET or JEE. So for this you take direct result of this without finding integration by parts, because when we find integration by parts, that proof requires many steps. Suppose for this we take one of the result. These are actually activity are given according to new syllabus, but if we take integral I is equal to first integral e raised to x into cos of bx plus c with respect to x. You may take here first function is e raised to x and second is v. You may take change of order because this is the proof or concept is fixed for this. So we take by ip that I becomes e raised to ax into integral of cos bx plus c dx minus outer integral, again integral cos bx plus c with respect to x, multiplying derivative of e raised to x and whole integral with respect to x. So here we take completion of the square bracket. So we take that value of I becomes e raised to x, integral of cos is here, sine bx plus c, and for the integral we take value, coefficient of x is divided, so sin bx plus c upon b minus this outer integral, same integral is repeated here, so we get sin bx plus c divided by b, and derivative of e raised to x, again derivative, again as it is, multiplying by this a, and whole integration with respect to x. Now here we take e raised to x upon b into sin of bx plus c. Here a upon b is the constant. Integral of sin bx plus c into e raised to x dx. Now for this integral, again we take, this is the second part of the integral. For this case, we take here double ip, integration by parts. For the same case, we take again by using method of ip. So again by ip means integration by parts, you take e raised to x as u and sine function is v, because same order is here. So for this I, e raised to ax upon b sine bx plus c minus a upon b, and from this we can use integration by parts. See here, we take direct step as first function is u, and multiplying by using same result, first function is u, multiplying integral of sine. What is integral of sine? That is minus of cos bx plus c upon b. Now after this step we take minus of integral, this minus integral cos bx plus c divided by b, and find integral of e raised to ax this bx plus c multiplied e raised to ax into a, all this integration with respect to x. Now here simplification check here. For the inner terms, this term is free. We take a upon b, this b is multiplied to b, this minus minus become plus. This term is free because there is no any operator for differential or integration. Now for second term, this minus minus become plus, but this minus remains as it is. So we get minus a upon this b multiplied to this b a, and this a multiplied to this a, means a square upon b square. So remember, second constant is a square upon b square. So we take simplification for this as that integral I becomes, first step for this, first term e raised to ax upon b into sin bx plus c. Now this a upon b is multiplied to inside, so we take that term as minus minus plus a upon b square e raised to ax cos bx plus c. Now for second, we take that is minus of, for second we take here that term becomes minus of integral. Now second term is separated from the previous step as this minus minus plus integral cos bx plus c into e raised to x. As you can take, this b is multiplied to b, this a is multiplied to a. So a square upon b square, but cos bx plus c into e raised to x, that is the first integral, that is I. We take that value of the integral I. So we get here e raised to ax into cos bx plus c with respect to x as a square upon b square, multiplying by a square upon b square. But this is nothing but I. So we get this I e raised to ax upon b sine bx plus c minus a upon b square e raised to ax cos bx plus c minus a square upon b square into I. This integral is given, that is I, and left side is again I. Shift this whole term to the left side. We get here this I plus a square upon b square times I is equal to e raised to x upon b sine bx plus c minus a upon b square times e raised to x into cos bx plus c. As we term, we can shift this third term. Now addition of this, now take down here I is common, 1 plus a square upon b square, that side remains as it is. Now here take addition again, I times b square plus a square upon a square, again that side remains as it is. Now check, value of I is equal to, this term is reverse here, a square upon b square plus a square. Again for right side, we get e raised to ax upon b sine bx plus c minus a upon b square e raised to ax into cos bx plus c. And that whole addition of, suppose we take, this is again multiplied to c1. So we take that constant is c2. B upon a square upon b square plus a square is multiplied to this c1. So that can be adjusted c2. Now simplification, as we take here, LCM is b square for these two terms. LCM is b square, and for this we take here multiplication of b, means b into sin bx plus c. From numerator we take e raised to x common. From numerator we take b raised to x is common. Here we get denominator contains b square. So बी स्क्वेयर अपॉन, वी राइट इन स्टैंडर्ड फॉर्म हियर आफ्टर टेकिंग एलसीएम, e raised to x into b square is common. Here one of the b is multiplied. Here b is multiplied. Here already b square. And term remaining are as this is the common term by multiplying b. Here remains minus a cos bx plus c and plus c. So this b square cancel with this b square, and we get final value of I e raised to x upon a square plus b square. Inside the bracket, we take as first constant a cos bx plus c minus b sine, we take here plus bx plus c plus c2. Now we check this sine minus, as this minus minus becomes plus. Second term we see here, that term becomes minus minus plus. So second term has plus sign, and therefore here that term, second term has plus sign, plus sign, plus here plus. So we take only change of this term, addition is commutative. So that result is over here. So you take this proof is never asked in the question paper, but you remember this result is very important. Only you can remember as that function with constant coefficient e raised to x upon a square plus b square, right? First variable is a and function as it is, and for second term start with second variable and write integration of this as integration of cos is sine. So this topic is over for the theoretical part. From next period we see examples on this topic. So thanks to all.